Okay. So, this is the second part of the course introduction. We have split the course introduction to three parts, and this is the second part, okay, which gives a overview of transfer phenomena. Okay. What is the outline? Origin of the subject, a transfer phenomena. What are the transfer phenomena as such? Okay. And then three levels of studying transfer phenomena. Okay. Okay, to know about the origin of the subject transfer phenomena, we will have to a little bit dig into the history of chemical engineering. And to do that, we should understand the term paradigm. Paradigm, if you look at the definition of the word paradigm, it says a specific way of viewing scientific reality, the way in which you look at a scientific reality. Okay. Other way of defining is the mindset of a scientific community. Let us say, if example, to quote an example, let us say from physics, first you had classical mechanics, then you had quantum mechanics. So, with the advent of quantum mechanics, the whole mindset of physics changed, whole way in which we look at physical theories changed, which means that the big paradigm change, paradigm shift has happened in let us say the respect to physics. Let us see what happened with respect to chemical engineering. Okay. To begin with, there are no paradigm in chemical engineering. Okay. Chemical processes were studied within the context of various industries. So, each industry was studied separately. Let us say industries for manufacture of soap, dye stuffs, sugar, sulfuric acid plant. A plan for manufacturing sulfuric acid was studied separately. Let us say another plan for manufacturing sodium hydroxide, that was studied separately. So, these every plant was studied separately. Okay. And without the mindset of unifying principle, and that is why we say there is no paradigm. We said paradigm is something mindset of unifying, and because to begin with there was no unifying mindset, we said there was no paradigm to begin with in chemical engineering. Okay. Now, slowly with the maturity of the field arrived the first paradigm, that was roughly in 1915. The first paradigm was the introduction of the concept of unit operations. So, what they realized was, we need not study each industry separately. The unit operations, namely equipments for heat transfer, momentum transfer, mass transfer, all same are similar across industries. So, it is enough you study the concept of unit operations, and so then you can apply to several industries. So, instead of studying industries, the focus came to unit operations. So, no longer a study of how to manufacture a specific commodity was required. If you understand unit operation concept, then you can apply to several processing plants. Study of unit operations became the focus. What is the necessity of this paradigm? Was systematization. Everything looked different, but you want to systemize all these chemical industries into the concept of unit operations. So, the necessity for systematization was the objective of first paradigm. Okay, what about the second paradigm in chemical engineering? The chemical engineering still more matured, and that saw the emergence of second paradigm in chemical engineering in the late 1950s. What is that second paradigm? The main reason, driver for that second paradigm is the textbook on transfer phenomena by Bird, Stewart and Lightfoot in 1960. That was the main driver. So, processes in any unit operations were the same in terms of momentum, energy and mass transport. So, now instead of looking at several unit operations, what realization came was that the principles or processes which takes place in any unit operation are the same, namely momentum, energy and mass transport. So, the study shifted from unit operations to these fundamental processes, so that you can, once you study these processes, you can study any unit operation and hence study any plant as well. Okay. So, what was the objective of this paradigm? what is the need? The need for a deep scientific knowledge of the phenomena. First paradigm need was systematization. Now the need was for a deep and scientific knowledge of the phenomena. To begin with, it was more of technology, chemical technology, slowly became chemical engineering, and then it became more of chemical engineering science. We extended chemical engineering to fundamental science, which means we linked it closely to physics, mechanics, thermodynamics and mathematics. That was the big change that was brought in by second paradigm. An engineering subject was linked to science, and so we extended chemical engineering to fundamental sciences, namely of physics, mechanics, thermodynamics and mathematics. This we call as a first principles approach. What do we do in a first principle approach? We analyze problems in terms of fundamental chemical and physical sciences, okay. Write down conservation equations to describe the phenomena. I remember that is what we did to begin with. We had a small tank, we wrote a mass balance. So, we write conservation equations to describe the phenomena and solve the equations. So, that is a first principles approach, which is analyzing in terms of physical principles and writing conservation equations on solving them. Okay. So, if you want to summarize this paradigms in chemical engineering, the first and second paradigm alone, to begin with, it were technologies. Technologies were split into unit operations. So, unit operations were split into transport processes. Okay. So, if you go from the reverse direction, if you understand transport processes, you can understand unit operations. If you can understand unit operations, you can understand technologies. What is the advantage of studying, let us say, technologies versus unit operations? Technologies can be infinite. Based on every chemical, there can be a technology. But when you come to unit operations, much more limited unit operations are there, can apply to vast number of technologies. Still, if you break down transport process, very limited transport processes, but with that you can explain lot of unit operations and extend to technologies. That is the advantage. So, technology has many possibilities, transport processes or physical principles are very few. With that you can remember we said the need for modeling is that you study very few principles applied for a wide range of processes. Exactly that is objective here. Okay. Okay. So, what are the transport phenomena? The first part we just had a slide saying that transfer phenomena includes fluid mechanics, heat transfer, mass transfer. We will little bit elaborate on that here. Okay. Okay. Subject of transfer phenomena includes three closely related topics: fluid mechanics, which deals with transport of momentum; heat transfer, transport of energy; mass transfer, which deals with transport of mass of various chemical species. Okay. Now, question arises why the three transfer phenomena should be studied together. Why do we always are beneficial to study these transfer phenomena together? Okay. Several reasons are there. First, we said we have split the unit operations into transfer processes. In many of the unit operations, multiple transfer phenomena happen together. Let us say you have a momentum transfer and heat transfer taking place, you have transport of heat and species taking place. So, many a times it is not just one transport phenomena which happens, multiple transport happens, and that is why it is advantageous to study them together. Okay. Second reason, the basic equations which govern this transfer phenomena are very closely related. Okay. This of course, you will see as we go along the course. Okay. And not alone the equations, the mathematical tools required to solve them are also very, very similar. Okay. And at the fundamental level, the molecular mechanisms are very closely related. Okay. That I would say a more fundamental reason to study all the three transport phenomena together. The molecular mechanism which cause the transport of momentum, energy and mass are all very closely related. That is also a reason why these transfer phenomena should be studied together. Okay. Okay. Now, what are the three levels, hierarchy of studying transfer phenomena? Okay. Now, describe the transport of momentum, energy and mass. Please note that whenever I say mass, it means mass of species here. Okay. So, we can do at three different levels. First is a macroscopic level and a microscopic level, and then of course, a molecular level. This use of words macro, micro and molecular depends on the book that is being followed. We will use the nomenclature based on our books which are going to follow. So, the meaning of macroscopic, microscopic and molecular depends on the book which you follow, and then we will restrict a particular scope. Okay. Okay, what is this macroscopic level of transfer phenomena? We write macroscopic balances over an entire equipment. Okay. What is shown here is a equipment wherein you have some inflow, you have some outflow, okay, and then there is some heat added and then some work added. Okay. Now, when you analyze this process at the macroscopic level, you write a balance equation, which means a conservation equation, and that is written over the entire equipment. Okay. So, macroscopic balances are written over an entire equipment, which are called as integral balance equations. Okay. What do they account for? They account for change due to introduction and removal through the entering and leaving streams. So, it accounts for whatever entering through the stream, leaving through the stream. What is entering? It could be momentum, it could be energy, it could be mass of species or total mass. Okay. And then what else does it account for? Various other inputs to the control volume from the surrounding. So, we have example for as examples, we have heat here, we have work here. Okay. So, integral balance accounts for whatever is entering through the inlet outlet streams and whatever interaction with the surroundings. Okay. Attention is not focused on the details like velocity, temperature, concentration profiles. Remember, when we discussed about difference between thermodynamic transfer phenomena approach, we said transfer phenomena approach can give us velocity profiles in a pipe, temperature profile in a furnace wall, and then the concentration profiles, etcetera. Integral approach, the macroscopic level description, integral balance does not pay attention, or we do not focus on these velocity profiles. We just write overall balance and account for whatever is crossing through the inlet outlet streams and whatever interaction the surroundings. Okay. Usually, we start the macroscopic description, which is much simpler. Okay. Most of the time, we result in either a algebraic equation, or if it is transient, we result in ordinary differential equation. Okay. Okay, let us look at the microscopic level. Microscopic balances are written over a small region equipment, which you call as a differential balances, and that is what is shown here. What is shown is taking a small region here, and that is shown magnified here, and you write a balance here, what is entering, leaving, etcetera. Okay. Earlier case, we took an entire equipment, we wrote the balances over the entire equipment. Here, we take a small volume inside the equipment. So, macroscopic balances are written over a small region and equipment, which are called differential balances, and that is what is shown symbolically here. Okay. Now, we describe changes in a small region, very, very small region. Okay. And in this approach, we get information about velocity profile, temperature profile, of course, pressure profiles, concentration profiles within an equipment. Okay. So, whenever we are interested in getting these profiles, we need to write a microscopic balance or differential balances, and then we will be able to get these velocity profile, which is much more detailed than just doing integral balance equation. So, detailed information required for better understanding of the process. Obviously, when you get the velocity profiles, concentration profiles, your understanding the process is much better, and microscopic balances helps in that way. Okay. Of course, the equations are much more difficult to solve, mostly result in partial differential equations. Okay. Okay. The molecular level, which is not within the scope of the present course, but just to introduce that, here we look at the molecular level, what happens between molecules, and we try to understand the mechanism of transfer phenomena in terms of molecular structure, intermolecular forces. We describe molecular motion in terms of velocities, momentum, etcetera. Okay. So, for example, here we apply the conservation laws for the collision between molecules. Okay. Of course, this goes takes transfer phenomena to the molecular level. This is not within the scope of this present course. Okay. Okay. So, three levels of studying transfer phenomena is associated with three length scales. When I say length scale, to give a quick description, length scale means length of the region over which you are writing the balance equation. Okay, to quick quick understanding. Okay. For example, if I in the first approach, it was a macroscopic approach where we wrote balance over the entire equipment, so which may be few centimeters to meters. So that's what I mean by length scale, order of magnitude, roughly what is the size of the equipment over which you write a balance equation. Okay. Why meters? You may write a balance, integral balance or a tall distillation column also over heat exchanger, which are a few meters long. Okay. The microscopic balance, as we have said, we write a take a small region inside the equipment and we write a balance equation. So, that size may be few microns to centimeters. So, we start describing at a local level and what is happening locally. So, the size of the domain over which we want to describe is order of micron to centimeters. Okay. That is why we are able to describe what is happening inside the equipment. Okay. Of course, molecular scale goes down up to hundreds or thousands of nanometer scale, okay, once again which is not within the scope of this level. Okay. So, this molecular mechanism is between molecules, so obviously the size length scale is of order of nanometers. Okay. Okay. To summarize this second part of the introduction, we saw transfer phenomena which emerged as the second paradigm in chemical engineering, and it involves three closely related topics, namely momentum, energy and mass transport, and they are all related. And there are three levels of description, namely molecular level, micro level and macro levels of description. And we are going to focus only on the microscopic and macroscopic levels of description in this course.